Hi, I just wanted to share this Yin Flow with you today. We will start in a comfortable seated posture, run through a short warm-up just to get the body fluid and moving, and then we'll run through about five postures, holding them for a little bit longer, between 2 and 3 minutes. For most of them, a couple of them will just be through a cycle of about 5 breaths. So to get started, we'll find this comfortable seated posture, cross-legged or whatever works for you, kneeling. You can always prop up if you need to, a little bit on a blanket. We might rock from side to side a little bit, helping us connect down through our root, connecting into the floor. And we'll start to listen to the sounds of the breath, closing the eyes gently. Starting to bring that breath down into the belly, filling all the way to the top of the chest. Squeezing all of the air out with the belly. Really starting to use the diaphragm. That next inhale, we're going to circle sweep the arms up overhead, opening the chest. With the exhale, we're going to fold forward, walking the hands out as far as we can in front of us, and then starting to slowly bring them from side to side, lengthening all the way from the armpit down through the hip, taking that little pause. We'll do this a few times. And as we come back through center, we'll start to walk that up. Dropping the chin down to the chest, we're going to roll one ear to the shoulder. And we'll release the chin to chest, rolling to the opposite side. Again, releasing chin to chest, we're going to roll back to that first side, walking the hand away from the body as far as we can, that opposite hand. And we'll bring the free hand up to the head, adding a little length in here. Starting to carry the breath into any tension that we're carrying in the neck here. Letting those exhales release the toxins that are binding it. Release the tension. That exhale, we'll release the hand to head from head, bringing the chin back to chest, rolling to that opposite side, walking the hand away from the body. Free hand comes up to the head. Again, with that exhale, we'll release the hand from the head, bringing the chin back to chest, and inhaling up through neutral. Next, we'll bring a thumbs up behind the back, bringing that hand up as far as we can reach between the shoulder blades. And we're going to let the head fall away from that shoulder. Again, we might bring that free hand up to add a little more length. that exhale, we'll release. Coming to the opposite side, bring that hand in between the shoulders as far as we can reach, letting the head fall away. Bring the hand up. Again, with exhale, we'll release. Inhaling to circle, sweep the arms up overhead. We'll grasp one wrist, reaching up and out to the opposite side, really opening the armpit here, keeping the rest of the body in alignment, grounded into the floor. We might bring that gaze up towards the ceiling. Inhale, up through center, switching wrists, lifting and out to the opposite side. Again, maybe bring that gaze up. And we'll come back through center and forward fold, walking those hands out as far as we can in front of us, releasing the tension in the neck and in the shoulders. And we'll inhale that back up. We're going to switch the direction that we have our feet crossed here. Finding those sit bones again. And we'll use that next inhale to circle sweep up overhead. With the exhale, we're going to twist in one direction. Starting to find that twist in the chest and in the belly. We're going to use that next inhale to lift up through the spine, out of the hips. And the exhale to see if we can twist into that shoulder, opening it behind us just a little bit more. Really nice big belly breaths here. Starting to activate the digestive system. And with that exhale, we'll release forward. Again, circle sweeping overhead. Exhaling to twist. Inhaling to lift, exhaling, seeing if we can go a little deeper. And we'll exhale, releasing forward. We're going to find the hands to the knees now. And we're going to work through seated cat and cow. Inhaling to roll the body forward. Bringing those shoulders back, squeezing them together. And with exhale, we'll round back through the shoulders, pushing all the air out as we squeeze in the belly. Finding the rhythm to our own breath here. using the same breath to movement. We're going to use that next inhale to draw the body forward, and we'll start to make large soupy circles with the upper body. Starting to build that internal flame, warming the body from the inside out. We use that next inhale to switch the direction of our rotation. Slowly start to tighten up that circle, coming back up to a neutral spine. Circle, sweeping those arms overhead one more time. And then we'll forward fold, walking those hands out as far as we can in front of us. And we'll walk that back up. The first posture that we'll go into today is dragon, which is a variation of a low lunge. So we'll move into a low lunge, bringing one leg forward, and we'll walk the opposite leg back as far as is comfortable for us. Remembering we'll be here for a little while, so making sure you're in a position on your knee that's comfortable for you. And we're going to start, we can either start here, there's several variations for all these postures, where we can be just kneeling over the knee, starting to try to plant the hands flat on the ground on either side of the foot. Or we can start to walk the hands inside of one foot and lean down in. We'll hold here for about a minute. Or as long as it's comfortable for our body. And we're going to start to shift the weight up, bring the hands to the knees at first, starting to sink down into the hips here. Or we might circle sweep the hands overhead, connecting them overhead, and open the chest up to the sky, leaning in here. Mini back bend, starting to open the chest. Yeah. Remembering only to hold these postures as long as it's comfortable for your body. And we'll start to release the arms down here. And we're going to twist the body open, away from that bent knee. Opening the hips a little bit here. And we'll start to release back forward, framing that foot with the hands. We'll switch sides, coming to that opposite side, bringing that foot forward, walking that opposite knee back as far as is comfortable for us, and starting to lean in. We might frame the foot with the hand, starting to try to plant the hand into the ground completely on either side of the foot, or bringing the hands into the inside of the foot and starting to lean down in. This is really great for opening the quad and the hip flexor. Remembering that if anything is feeling really tight or just hard, finding that breath can really help to center us, bring us back in. The breath is a great tool. Its main purpose is to remove toxins from the body, things that our bodies can't use, and bring oxygen and nutrients into us. We'll start to come up, bringing the hands up to the knees to start, and sinking into those hips. We might stay here, or we can start to circle sweep those hands overhead, leaning in. Mini back bend here. And we'll start to bring ourselves up, and we're going to twist away from that knee, opening the body here. And we'll release that forward, bringing both legs back. And we're going to move into a yin child's pose. Bringing the knees together, the bum towards the heels as far as we can. We'll start to walk the head down towards the floor, reaching the arms around towards the heel, folding over the body. And we'll inhale that back up. We're going to come back to a seat. And our next posture that we're going to do is dragonfly. So we'll come to a wide-legged straddle, engaging the legs here, toes up towards the ceiling. We might give ourselves a little lift up, finding the seat there, connecting down through the root, making sure we can still tilt the pelvis here. And we're going to come into a forward fold. In yin, we want to start to let the back round, drawing the head down towards the floor as we walk the hands out, allowing the deep connective tissue along the spine to start to lengthen. And we'll go ahead and inhale that back up, releasing the legs forward, giving them a little shake. Our next posture is saddle. So we're going to come back around onto the feet, kneeling. And this is the beginning of saddle. We can stay here, starting to lift up through the upper body, through the spine, through the crown of the head, opening that chest. Or we can start to walk the hands out behind us, leaning back in, letting the head drop. We might start to try to work our way down onto the elbows. Or the crown of the head. And the full posture, we come down onto the shoulders here. Deep quadricep stretch. remembering it's okay to try something different, go a little deeper. And if that just isn't speaking to your body today, working yourself out to a variation that works for you. And we'll start to walk that back up. And again, folding forward into that child's pose, letting the lower back release. Bring that back up. Next, we're going to go through half frog, extending one leg out in front of us, pulling those toes back towards us. We're going to bring the opposite leg behind us. We want to try and find a 90 degree angle at the knee joint and at the groin. And once we've set up there, we'll go ahead and lift the body up again, making sure we're sitting solidly planted on this leg. We don't want to be rolling out on a hip because of a tight groin. That doesn't help us find that flexibility and start to work into it. So once we found ourselves situated, we'll take a nice deep inhale into the belly. And with that exhale, we'll start to round ourselves down, drawing the head towards the knee. And we'll inhale that back up, releasing the leg from behind us. Sorry, kitten. And we'll come to that opposite side. Again, drawing the foot back towards us, starting to bring that leg behind, finding the 90 degree angle in the groin and the knee. Ooh. lifting to set ourselves solid on the extended leg. Nice deep inhale into the belly, lifting up, exhaling to start to draw that head down towards the knee. And we'll inhale that back up, releasing the leg forward. Give a little shake. And our last posture we're going to do today is camel pose. So again, we'll come to the knees. We want to make sure the knees are aligned underneath the hips. And then one of the most important aspects of camel pose is no matter how far you can lean back into it, where you can reach, keep those hips pushed forward and aligned over the knees. We don't want to jeopardize that and start to lean back so that we can reach the heels. So I teach this posture by bringing our hands around to our back pockets, squeezing the elbows together to start to open the chest. Take a nice deep inhale into the belly. And with that exhale, we're just going to start to let the hands slide down the thighs, opening the throat and the chest, letting them come down as far as they will. We'll take 5 deep belly breaths here and come back to child's pose. We'll inhale that back up, and we're going to come down to the back now, starting to settle in for that Shavasana. So we'll come down to the back. We're going to draw the knees up to the chest. Maybe roll a little bit on the hips here on the back. And then we want to cross the legs at the knees, bringing the arms out to the sides. And we're going to let the legs fall in the direction of that bottom knee, the one that's on the bottom of our cross. Keeping the shoulders connected with the floor, we might bring that hand up to the top of the knee
to help us sink in just a little bit deeper. We're going to inhale those knees back up, switching sides, crossing the opposite side, and letting the knees fall down in. Maybe adding that extra weight. And we'll inhale those knees back up, giving them one more squeeze into the chest, maybe rocking from side to side a little bit. We're going to let the legs fall down to the ground, spreading them wide, setting up for pentacle. We'll bring the arms overhead, spreading them wide, gently closing the eyes. Start to draw the breath down into the belly again. Nice deep breaths, pushing all that air out. We'll give the toes and the fingertips a little wiggle, letting out their energy, walking the shoulders down the back. We'll allow gravity to pull the backs of the heels, the calves and the thighs, the hips, shoulders and the back of the head deeper into the floor. We'll soften through the belly, chest and the jaw, starting to relax the mind. Gently allowing the thoughts to go where they need to. Thank you. leaving the eyes closed, you'll start to wiggle the toes and the fingertips, bringing that prana back into the body. We'll draw together the feet and then the hands, and we'll lengthen all the way from the toes up through the fingertips. The eyes still closed, we're going to roll to one side of the body, cradling the head, resting there. We'll slowly start to bat open the eyelashes, drawing the gaze of the eyes from the left and to the right. Back to the left and to the right again. We'll use that next inhale to push ourselves up, coming back to that comfortable seated posture. I always like to end my yin practice with some gentle self-massage, a little bit of pranayama, and some mantra and mudra. So we will start with three cleansing breaths, allowing the body to remove any toxins that we've loosened in our bodies during this practice. We'll take a nice deep inhale into the belly, letting it fill all the way to the top of the chest. And we'll force that air out the mouth. Again, inhaling. One more time. We're going to take our middle three fingers up to the collarbone. And we'll start to tap there. We're going to let those same fingers fall behind the collarbone. And we're going to gently start to press down in, pulsing very slowly, softly. You might start to feel a little nasal drip here. It's perfectly normal. This is a cleansing massage, starting to drain our lymphatic system. Next, we'll take the hands. We're going to spread apart the ring finger and the middle finger and wrap that around the ears, letting the hands cup the face. And we'll start to pull down. Again, very gently, slowly. We're going to bring the hands all around to the shoulder blades and start to pat the back here. A nice pat on the back. Your job well done. Loosening those shoulders.
to take the index and middle finger to the base of the skull where that little divot is. And we're going to start to draw circles there. We're going to start in a counterclockwise direction. And we'll change the direction of that rotation. Going to do naughty breathing next, which is a great way to balance the energies in our body. So we're going to use the thumb and the pinky to close nostrils, and we'll bring the middle three fingers up to the third eye, which is where the pineal gland is located. So the vibration from our breath will help stimulate our pineal gland. So we'll start by closing that right nostril, and we'll take a nice deep inhale through the left. Closing the left, opening the right to exhale. Again, inhaling. We'll close the right, opening the left to exhale. Starting to find your own rhythm here. We always want to end this practice by coming back around to that exhale on the left side of the body. So last, we'll close this practice with some gentle mudra mantra. Mudras are hand gestures. So the gesture that we are going to practice today is the Shakti Mudra. We'll bring the thumbs around to the inside of the hand, palm, wrapping the index and middle finger around it. We're going to bring those two fingers together, the outside edges, and then start to align the fingertips of the ring finger and the pinky. The mantra we'll be doing today is very simple. Om Shanti 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 Om. Connecting us all, bringing us all peace. Nice deep inhale into the belly, filling to the top of the chest. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Allow that vibration to resonate in our bodies for a moment. Bring the hands around to heart center, pushing together through the palms and the fingertips, the Anjali Mudra. We're going to peel open those middle three fingers, forming a lotus cup. We'll use that next inhale to lift our lotus out of the murky waters, filling it with all the beauty, abundance, we have in our lives, everything that makes us whole, all of the love. And as we reach overhead, we'll start to push those fingertips back together, sealing this in. And bring the hands to the forehead to honor our thought, to the lips to honor our speech, into the heart to honor right action. Namaste.